Hey, good afternoon, guys. This is Matt, and I wanted to talk to you more about the minimum wage right now. And man, I really can't remember the last time I started making minimum wage. I mean, I started stopped earning minimum wage before I was probably 17 or 18, and then I just started having better jobs, you know, since then. So I was totally clueless. I plead ignorance that I did not know what the minimum wage was. I'm still not clear. I think in Florida it's seven something. Eight. I have to look at the map again because I was bouncing around looking at all the states inside this blog post. If you click on each state, you can find out what the minimum wage is. So I included that link on this blog post. But when I looked at some of them, some were like $5. Some states were $5. I'm like, $5 is some change. They're like, how do people survive off of $5? I was having trouble doing that when I was 17, you know? But I guess that's the sign of the times. But what's happened? I mean, why isn't the minimum wage higher? I mean, you got all these politicians, they say they're going to do this and that for us, and they get into office and nothing changes. You know, they make a lot of promises, though, and we vote for them, you know, not me, but, you know, they vote for them, and nothing changes. So it's like, why is minimum wage so low still? It does not compute. I mean, it's barely keeping up with inflation. So it's like, you know, do you want to continue down that path or do you want to start a home business? Because even if you're on minimum wage, the great thing is you can still start a home business because it's the cost of entry is so low. The point of entry is so low, $25, you know. But I'm just amazed that the minimum wage isn't higher. You know, I guess I've been out of the loop too long. All right, guys, this is Matt. I appreciate your comments. Leave a comment below. Talk to you later. Peace.